Hey guys, what's going on? It's your boy, Bowser Jr. Fan 13, and today we are back at it again with another top 10! Yeah, you guys are missing all these top 10s, aren't you? Because today's top 10 will be discussing my top 10 favorite Mortal Kombat characters. I love Mortal Kombat. It's one of the best gruesome violent fighting games of all time, and I just really enjoy the game, not just for its violent gameplay and such. I love the soundtrack of the game, I love the iconic characters and the story. So while I'm discussing my favorite characters, I'll be talking about like their origins a little bit, their gameplay styles, what I like about them, and my favorite fatalities. Keep in mind, I won't say what's my favorite fatalities from each character because probably because I can't make up my mind of which fatality I love the best, but for some of them I will. I won't say it for the honorable mentions. I'll keep it all short because I have a lot of honorable mentions. So anyway, without further ado, let's get into this action, shall we? Number 10, we have Sub-Zero. Sub-Zero has got to be one of the coolest and most iconic fighting game characters of all time. I mean, without Sub-Zero and Scorpion, it wouldn't feel like Mortal Kombat because these characters have been in literally every Mortal Kombat up to this date. What I like about Sub-Zero, I mean, his design, even though he's a blue ninja, he has the power of ice, and I mean like an ice cryomancer ninja. That's the first time anyone has ever come up with that, because I have a feeling that Mortal Kombat was the first franchise to ever come up with a character that can shoot ice. So anyways, the first Sub-Zero named Bi-Han, he died at the hands of Scorpion and became Noob Saibot. I'll get to that later. And his brother, Kuai Liang, decides to take his place up to the most recent Mortal Kombat game. I love his moves. I mean, even though he freezes people, he does it with style. He can shape ice into whatever weapons he wants. It's pretty awesome. My favorite fatality from Sub-Zero is his classic one where he rips off your head alongside with the spinal cord. It's just so gruesome and so satisfying to see. And that's why Sub-Zero is at number 10. Number 9, we have Baraka. Baraka is part of the Tarkatan race that comes from Outworld, and he's loyal to Shao Kahn and anyone else who rules it. So, yeah. As a character, I feel like Baraka is like the most underrated character. I mean, I love his design. He looks so deadly and so ferocious and scary. I mean, you gotta admit, he's so cool. And if I'm gonna be honest, the reason why I love Baraka is probably because of my boy Dashy. I mean, he loves Baraka. Anyways, I love his movesets. He fights with his fist blades. He can shoot beams out of the fist blades. And he could bite his opponents. It's pretty common, judging by his design. My favorite fatality is the one from Mortal Kombat 2, where he stabs you in the stomach and he lifts you up with his fist, and then you slowly slide down in between his blades. And that's gotta be scary, being put up into the air and being impaled with the blades. And the last thing you have to see before you die is his most scary and terrifying face. Like, that is like such a scary way to die, and I love it. And that's why Baraka is at number 9. Number 8, we have Shao Kahn, the ruler of Outworld and the most iconic villain in Mortal Kombat history. Shao Kahn made his debut in Mortal Kombat 2, and he is like literally one of the most hardest bosses that you have to fight in Mortal Kombat history. I mean, can you blame me? Shao Kahn is really difficult. I mean, when I played Mortal Kombat 2, depending on whatever mode you're playing, it doesn't matter. I can never reach Shao Kahn because he's just too freaking difficult alongside some of the sub-bosses. Mortal Kombat 3, I think he's got to be like the most hardest version of all time. I enjoy his gameplay. He's really cool. He has these arrows that he shoots. He can use his hammer. He loves to taunt his opponents, like, "You will die, mortal." I mean, is there really any doubt that Shao Kahn would be a not good character? Because, I mean, come on, this dude will take whatever he wants and he'll do it however he wants it. And that's why Shao Kahn is at number 8. Number 7, we have Cabal. Cabal made his debut in Mortal Kombat 3. He was originally part of the Black Dragon Clan with Kano and the others, but he decided to quit and join the police force with Striker. But things don't go well for him, as he was burnt to a crisp by King Taro, and because of this, he's forced to put on a different outfit and wear a mask, which he needs to survive. So basically, he looks like a freak. Dang, I feel really bad for the dude. As a fighter, he is no slouch. He is like the most fastest character in Mortal Kombat. Like, he literally runs super fast. Like, you can get your opponents dizzy and leave them open. He has his hook chains, which is his main weapon of choice. He can shoot beams out of his mask, and he can also summon saw blades, which is pretty cool. Overall, Cabal is just a really awesome character. My favorite fatalities? Well, I have two in mind. One of them's kind of dumb, but the other one is pretty cool. Hear me out, though. My favorite first fatality is the one where he takes off his mask, revealing his ugly face, and then he shows it to his opponents, and they get so scared that literally their soul comes out, the body, like, lays dead, but the soul runs away in fear. I mean, yeah, it's not a good fatality, and I can see why people don't like it, but I think it's funny and cool. They made it into a brutality in Mortal Kombat 11, which is so awesome. My other favorite fatality is the one from Mortal Kombat 11 where he puts his hook chains on his opponent, and he runs so fast, like literally super, super fast, that all of his opponent's body parts keep falling off the more he keeps on going further. I mean, I'm like, dang, I would not want to go on a run with him. So anyways, that's why he's at number 7. Number 6, we have the God of Thunder and Protector of Earthrealm, Raiden. Raiden has to be one of the coolest characters to have ever lived. He spends most of his life protecting Earthrealm and trying to stop the villains from taking over the world and stuff like that. He tries his best to, like, make everything right, and even though he kind of screwed everything up in the second timeline, at least in Mortal Kombat 11, he tried to make things right. Raiden sure has a whole lot going for him, doesn't he? As a fighter, I love his moveset. As a Thunder God, he shoots lightning, so there's not much to expect. He can shoot a whole bunch of different types of lightning. I love his move where he, like, literally flies at you. I just love that. It's so amazing. My favorite fatality has to be the one from Mortal Kombat 2 where he grabs you and he shocks you to death until you explode. So overall, Raiden is really cool, and that's why he's at number 6. Number 5, we have Cyrax. Cyrax is part of the Cyber Lin Kuei, and I love his design. He's a robot, but I love the yellow palette color on him. Because of all of the robot ninjas that you play as, Cyrax looks cool because, I mean, yellow is my favorite color. And as a fighter, Cyrax is just pretty cool. Story-wise, basically the Lin Kuei was going to be turned into a robot, but Cyrax was opposed to this, but he ends up turning into a robot against his own will. Dang. What is it with characters being forced to do stuff against their own will? Like, that is so messed up. As a fighter, Cyrax is really cool. He has a net where he can trap his opponent. He shoots bombs. Pretty much what you expect for a robot to do. He's pretty amazing and pretty cool. My favorite fatality from him. Alright, this one, again, it's kind of dumb, but I actually enjoy this one. He basically goes into his little arm and taps on his buttons and activates his self-destruct sequence. And not only does he die, but his opponents die as well. I mean, that's kind of a weird suicide fatality to come up with, but I think it's pretty amazing. In fact, he's like, if I must go down, then I'm taking you with me, or something like that, or I'm taking you with me, or I don't know how to put this reference, but you guys get what I'm saying. I think if they brought back the Harakiris, this should definitely be Cyrax's Harakiri, because, I mean, what can I say? It looks pretty cool. So Cyrax is at number 5. Number 4, we have a Shaolin monk warrior named Kun Lao. Kun Lao, design-wise, you may look at him and be like, well, he's just a guy with a hat. But not just any hat, because that hat is his weapon. I never thought that clothes could actually be a weapon. That is pretty cool. So he fights using his hat and using all of his Shaolin monk moves, like martial arts and stuff. It's pretty basic. So yeah. He spends most of his time protecting Earthrealm alongside Raiden and Liu Kang, so not much needs to be said about him. My favorite fatality from him is his fatality from Mortal Kombat 4, where he literally slices your whole body in half, like, the whole body, like, and then, like, as you go on your knees, your body starts splitting up and you see all of your insides. It's kind of gross, but it's so enjoyable to see. Dang, what is wrong with me? I mean, it's a fighting game with violence, but what did you expect? So anyways, Kun Lao is at number 4. Number 3, we have one of my favorite female fighters in Mortal Kombat history, Melina. Melina is a genetic clone made with Tarkatan blood and supposed to be like the twin sister of Kitana. And she basically has this obsession with wanting to bond with Kitana and so that they could be sisters. But she's also jealous so that she could also get the throne and rule alongside Shao Kahn and such and such. I mean, it's kind of confusing, but hey, what can you say? She's a really good fighter, and she's very wicked. If you see her under her mask, you see that she has this big, massive teeth. It makes her look frightening and not really beautiful, but hey, I think even though she has stuff like that, she looks beautiful overall. Her fighting skills, well, of course she wants to eat her opponents and bite them. She fights with her size. She can roll into a ball like Sonic the Hedgehog. She can drop up from the air and do these teleport kicks. And yeah. Also, her fingernails are like so sharp that one of her fatalities in Mortal Kombat X, she can literally rip you to pieces with those nails. And I'm like, dang, why do characters like, I've never seen a character that has sharp nails like that. Well, maybe I have, but whatever. Anyways, but that's not my favorite fatality. My favorite fatality from her is the one from Mortal Kombat 2, where she takes off her mask and she looks like she's about to kiss you, but she ends up sucking you up, your whole entire body, and she throws up all of your bones. Dang. So overall, Melina is beautiful and one of the best female fighters in history, and that's why she's at number 3. Number 2, we have the champion of Mortal Kombat himself, Liu Kang. When it comes to martial arts movies, whether if it's Bruce Lee, Jackie Chan, or whatever type of martial artist you could think of, Liu Kang has got to be one of the most iconic martial arts characters of all time. As a character himself, he's basically the main hero of Mortal Kombat. He defeated Shang Tsung and Shao Kahn. I don't know if he defeated Shinnok and Onaga. I can't remember. I know he defeated Kronika and he became a fire god, which was pretty cool. I love his movesets. He throws fireballs, can do dragon kicks, bicycle kicks. It's so amazing. And yeah, that's pretty much it. Overall, I believe Liu Kang has got to be one of the coolest characters of all time. My favorite fatality from this dude is the one from Mortal Kombat 2, where he turns into a dragon and he eats his opponents. And I'm like, whoa, now that is cool. So Liu Kang is at number 2. Before we get to my final pick of the list, As always, and as usual, here are my
Bowser Jr. Fan 13 honorable mentions.
Noob Saibot. As I said before when discussing Sub-Zero, he was the first Sub-Zero Bihan, but he ends up getting killed by Scorpion. He gets resurrected by Quan Chi and becomes this ninja of shadows, which is pretty neat. Having to control darkness and stuff, it's so cool. Scarlet. Basically, Scarlet was originally a rumor discussed back in the days saying that there was going to be a red katana who was going to be a playable character or a secret fighter that you could fight. And apparently, Ed Boon took notice of it and he decided to make that character an actual character in Mortal Kombat 9. And it was cool seeing her back in Mortal Kombat 11. What I like about this character is that she has the power to use blood as a weapon. Dang! I never knew someone could actually use blood to her advantage. Reptile. He was originally a secret fighter that you could fight in Mortal Kombat 1. Then they made him an actual playable character and his own character in Mortal Kombat 2, giving him his own moveset and his own story. He's pretty cool. Ermac. This was another character who was basically a rumor and basically one of those myths that people keep on saying that there's a red ninja character who was going to be playable. So they made Ermac a playable character, of course. What I like about him is that he's a warrior made out of a whole bunch of dead warrior souls. And I'm like, wow, that is cool. Johnny Cage. Basically, he's just your generic popular movie star who's seeking fame. He gets thrown into this tournament of death and kills. I mean, it's kind of funny that he's very unaware of all the stuff that is going on until he finally realizes all that stuff. I love what they did with him in Mortal Kombat 11 because the way his character evolved in the future was amazing. Sonya Blade. The first female character playable in Mortal Kombat, and she's one of the toughest characters of all time. She works for the Special Forces, and she is, like, without a doubt, like, literally one of the toughest fighters. Jackson Briggs, or otherwise known as Jax. He's Sonya's partner, who also works in the Special Forces, and he's really cool. I love his metallic arms, they make him look awesome. And he is future Damon's worst nightmare. Hey Damon, you remember your Mortal Kombat 3 video? Princess Katana. She was a female ninja character introduced in Mortal Kombat 2. And basically, after she found out the truth about her past and Shao Kahn killed her father and took her mother, like, to rule the world, she decides to betray him and work alongside Liu Kang and Earthrealm to become a good girl. And that's really awesome for her. Jade. She's Katana's best friend. She fights on the good side alongside her. She uses ninja stars and a pole to fight her opponents. She even has this cool move where she can literally run into projectiles and not get hurt. Rain. This is another character that was rumored to be in Mortal Kombat 3. Man, people must really love rumored characters, and Ed Boon must really love ninja palette swapped characters. But this isn't just your average ninja swapped character. He has the power to control the weather. He uses lightning and water. One cool fact about this dude is that he's named after Purple Rain from the dancer or singer Prince, which is pretty neat. Takeda, by far one of the most coolest characters in Mortal Kombat X. He has a pretty good moveset. He is part of the Shirai Ryu and he's Kenshi's son. Man, I'm sad that they didn't bring him back in Mortal Kombat 11. I mean, he does make a cameo appearance, but come on, Ed Boon, make him a playable character. Kano. This Australian killer who basically is the leader of the Black Dragon clan, and he'll basically do whatever he wants and kill whoever anyone wants, basically for money. He does anything for money or stuff like that. So yeah, Goro, Prince of the Shokan race, this basically half-human, half-dragon race. He is originally one of the champions of Mortal Kombat, but he ends up losing and dying at the hands of Liu Kang. But don't underestimate this dude. He is like the most toughest, biggest beast of all time. Even with like with his four arms, you clearly have no advantage beating him. Sindel, the Queen of Edenia, who lost her husband because of Shao Kahn. She was brainwashed and manipulated by him to kill her daughter, Kitana, but she was saved. In Mortal Kombat Deception, Kitana was working for evil and Sindel saved her. Oh, that was so beautiful. And I love her moveset. Basically, she uses the power of screams and her hair to fight her opponents. Shang Tsung, one of the most deadliest sorcerers in Mortal Kombat and the first villain in Mortal Kombat series. I love this dude's Mortal Kombat 11 and movie incarnation because, I mean, 11 pays a homage to the movie with the whole, "Your soul is mine." And the personality and stuff like that, it's just flawless. Or a flawless victory, if you like to say it. Aaron Black. This killing bounty hunter guy, he comes from Earthrealm, but ends up betraying Outworld. He was originally part of the Black Dragons clan, but now he just picks whatever sides he wants and does whatever he likes. His morality, I mean, it's no contest. I mean, he clearly is a villain, but his choices with siding with the good guys or the bad guys, it's so mysterious. Quan Chi, the sorcerer who works for Shinnok and basically follows his orders and does what he pleases or whatever he wants to do. Oh my god, that was a lot of honorable mentions. But hey, I needed to get all of them out there. Well, now that I'm done with that, it's time to reveal my number one favorite character. Number one on the list, I mean, is pretty obvious. You guys already know who it is, so bring him out. Number one, we have Scorpion, who also goes by the name Hanzo Hisashi. So, before Scorpion became himself, he was a man who was the leader of the Shirai Ryu clan, and he was a loving father and husband. But his family and his clan ends up getting killed because of Quan Chi disguising himself as Sub-Zero. So he basically puts the blame on Sub-Zero and kills Scorpion. Then he resurrects him as his hell-spawned specter. And so Scorpion now is a merciless, vengeful spirit who wants to get revenge on Sub-Zero and seek vengeance for his family and clan. But eventually he finds out the truth in Mortal Kombat X and Mortal Kombat 4 and starts to kill Quan Chi, and his vengeance is fulfilled. But now he spends the rest of his days protecting Earthrealm alongside the good guys. That's awesome. Because at first, it was pretty cool that he became a ninja who trusts no one and does whatever he pleases and whatever he feels like is right. Then he starts coming to his senses and becomes a full good guy. Man, that is so awesome. I love his moveset. It's so cool. Shooting fire, teleporting everywhere. He uses his swords. I love his iconic sphere move. Get over here! I mean, come on. It's just so awesome. You can't deny that it's so cool. Anyways, there are a lot of fatalities that I love from Scorpion. It was hard for me to choose all of them because they're all so cool, with an exception of a few, but it's just there's so much that are so cool, I can't really choose one. But because this is a top 10 list, if I have to choose one of the best fatalities, it's obviously the classic one. I love the fatality where he rips off his face, revealing a skeleton full of fire. And he breathes fire and burns his opponents to a crisp. And I'm like, dang, he just roasted them. Toasty! So overall, Scorpion is the most iconic and most coolest character of them all. If there's a Mortal Kombat game without Scorpion, I would not play it, because you have to have Scorpion in the game if you want me to play. And that's why Scorpion will and forever and always will be my number one favorite Mortal Kombat character. And that's all we have for today. Let me know in the comments down below who is your favorite Mortal Kombat character, and I'll see you guys in the next video. Peace out, everyone.